This is part two about how to think about the market within our Basics of Professional Betting series. We need to distinguish between objective probabilities and subjective probabilities. Betting with objective probabilities refers to situations where the true probabilities of an event occurring are known or can be accurately calculated. As a result, it becomes close to impossible for bettors to find value in these markets, since the odds are already adjusted to reflect the objective probabilities. On the other hand, subjective probabilities involve situations where individuals assess the likelihood of an event based on their own judgment, models, or analysis. The more subjective a probability is, the more cautious a bettor has to be. For example, it has huge influence on correct money management. In sports betting, the odds are subjective. The estimated probabilities by different professionals will always slightly differ. There is no perfect model which can estimate the odds of a sports match with a 100% accuracy. We introduce a very simple coin toss game, as we can demonstrate important trading concepts of it in the following videos. You need to understand that trading a sports match is basically just a much more complicated version of trading a coin toss game. The main difference is, as we have explained before, that with coin flipping we have objective probabilities. But that comes in handy here, as we don't have to think too much about what are the fair odds. Everybody would agree that it's 50% heads and 50% tails. The market would maybe look like that if there isn't much liquidity. Now, I kid you not, there are many people who would take these odds, and if you ask them afterwards if they weren't aware that they took negative value, a typical answer would be, "What do you want? I won, so fuck off." What do we see here? Is there any value? Of course not. Some people have put orders in. They are hoping for someone to come by and take their odds, which would give them a value bet. If you come to any betting market, you should always assume that the people who have put in their orders already know what they are doing. As we have explained in one of our misconceptions about professional betting videos, there is no magic money lying around. It's possible to find value, but you have to assume that your counterparts have done their homework. What you actually could do if you want to bet here, you could for example put in a lay bet at 1.96 for player A and hope you will get matched. Here in our coin flip game, that would be a sure value bet. But if you are in a real sports betting market, where you have estimated the odds to be 2.0, you can never be so sure about it. Your estimation could be wrong. There could be insiders betting, or the match could even be fixed. So we'd have to reduce our staking and possibly even add a security margin. Let's take a look at Betfair's exchange games, as that's actual betting with objective probabilities, and we can show what's the problem here. These games are basically coin flip games, just a little bit more complicated. It's quite easy to calculate the objective probabilities for the outcomes, for example in the Texas Hold'em game. You can bet on which of the four hands will be the best in a kind of simulated Texas Hold'em game, where all hands stay in play until all cards are revealed to see who is the winner. We have semi-real betting markets here, which look like the real betting markets and technically work almost the same. However, it's basically just a Betfair bot putting in odds. Let's take a look. A new round begins. And no card is revealed yet. Do you understand what's going on here? The bot instantly calculates the objective probabilities and places its orders accordingly. Obviously, the fair odds are 4.0 with no cards revealed yet. You will always get negative value if you make a bet here. And we just saw someone actually made a bet. Now the whole cards are revealed and the bot instantly puts in new orders. The bot can't be wrong. He has a perfect estimated odds. The probability of each hand winning is an objective probability. You can sit down and work it out exactly. It's no problem for the bot, of course, to do this instantly. Let's watch until the end. More cards are revealed and you can see more bets are made. If I remember correctly, there were 4 to 5 tickets amounts matched in each game when this came out. I literally got the answer I just told you when I tried to explain to someone why it's stupid to get involved here. What do you want? I won, so fuck off. Ironically, this is the reason it's actually possible to make money in sports betting. Because sometimes you're up against such people who lack basic understanding of probability. However, most of the time you're up against more sophisticated people, so you better expect that to be the case and educate yourself to survive in the markets. In the next video, we'll go more deep on our coin flip game and we chuckle a bit with exchange odds and commission rates.